Well, hello, my name is Christopher Scott and I serve as a small groups pastor at a local church. In this video, I'm going to talk to you about how to use the Managing Our Finances God's Way small group study in your small group through your church, right? So in this video, I'm going to talk to you about how you want to prepare to facilitate this study. What are some of the basic formats you want to have in your study? I'll give you some basic tips for facilitating a small group. And then also I'll give you a brief overview of this curriculum just so you have a little feel for it before you go through it. So first, let me talk to you about how you want to prepare for a study like this. This study uses a DVD curriculum. So how you want to prepare for that is a little different than if you were doing like a verse by verse Bible study. And how you want to prepare for a DVD-based curriculum is that about a month before the group starts, you wanna make sure you get your study guides and your DVDs, and you wanna put the DVD in the DVD player and make sure it works, number one. Sometimes you get the DVD and it's defective, it doesn't work for whatever reason, so you wanna get that DVD, put it in your DVD player, make sure it works, okay? Then secondly, you wanna make sure you have the correct study guides that go along with that DVD. So let the DVD maybe play a little bit, follow along in the study guide, make sure it's the right study guide for that DVD. Additionally, you want to make sure you have enough study guides. Always make sure you have plenty of study guides. One of the things about the small groups at our church, one of the cultures of our small group ministry that I really want to instill is that we're always going to have extra study guides. That I don't want anybody to worry about not having enough or trying to, you know, segment, or if this person stops coming, they got to get it back. No, we're always going to just have plenty of study guides. They're cheap. It's easy to get more. Just make sure you got plenty as you're starting out. Third thing you want to do is you want to adjust the zoom on your TV, okay? So TVs have a thing called zoom where you can zoom in the picture and the picture gets bigger, right? So for example, as my hand gets closer to the screen, you see that my hand goes down below out of the screen, okay? And that's because the picture is getting zoomed in and you're getting closer. And the same thing sometimes happens with DVD players and TVs. People will zoom in the TV or not even realize it. But then when you have a DVD curriculum such as this, there's notes that come up at the bottom of the screen and those notes will get pushed down below the screen. So you wanna make sure that the notes actually show up on the bottom of the screen and adjust your zoom if needed. Fourth thing you wanna do is get acquainted with the small group leader resources. This one, Managing Finances God's Way, has some great small group leader resources in the back, starting on page, I believe, 104. There's some great tips, things like that. It's actually page 99, some great helps for hosts that the folks at Saddleback Church and Purpose Driven Ministries have provided. It's got some good suggestions for how to facilitate a group, how to organize snacks, prayer requests, things like that, okay? So that's what you want to do about a month before. You want to do those four things. Test the DVD, make sure you have the correct study guides and enough study guides. You want to adjust the zoom on your TV and then read through the helps for hosts starting on page 99 in the back of this book, okay? So that's what you want to do about a month before your group begins. Then what you want to do each week before your group starts is you want to, first, you want to watch the DVD, okay? Pop in the DVD player, watch the DVD, take the notes. That's the first thing you want to do. Second thing you want to do is you want to look through the notes in the back of the study guide. Make sure you got the fill in the blanks correctly. See if those are correct for you and make sure you got the correct fill in the blanks. Third, if there's any passages referenced in the video, maybe you wanna look those up in a study guide, right? Make sure you, or a study Bible or a commentary, make sure you have a good feel for those passages and the context and what's being talked about. And then lastly, what you wanna do is you wanna answer the questions in the discussion areas, right? So there's a couple different discussion areas in each lesson. Go ahead and spend some time and jot down your thoughts and answers to those. So that's how you want to prepare to facilitate the small group. Both a month before the group begins, you want to do a few things. Then each week, you're going to have your own personal time of preparation where you watch the DVD, fill in the blanks, and answer the questions, okay? So how do you want to format a group like this? What is it format supposed to be like, and what elements do you want to have in your group? Well, there's two things you're going to want to do every single week in order. And those two things in order is obviously you want to watch the DVD first and then go through to the discussion guide, okay? And really, we can probably say three things, okay? With this curriculum, you want to do the getting started areas, right? It's going to have you maybe talk about some of the homework, some of the things they've done. You want to do that first, then watch the DVD, and then you want to go through the discussion guide. So that's really three things you want to do each and every week in order, is to do the getting started, watch the DVD, and then go through the discussion questions as a group. There's two additional elements you wanna start as your small group as well. that you want to do each week. You can do them either before those three elements or after those three elements. It doesn't matter. You just want to make sure you do them at the same time each week. You want to follow the same order each and every week, okay? And those two things are prayer and snacks, right? So you can start the group out with some prayer time, asking for prayer requests among the group. You can start the group out with snacks, or you can do both at the end. I know my small group, we do the study first, and then we do prayer at the end. We have a guy that coordinates prayer in our small group. It's not me as a facilitator. It's another guy that coordinates the prayers and reads the prayers and prays. And then we do snacks after that. And we follow the same order. But you can do them at the beginning. You can do snack time as they're getting there and getting acquainted. You can do prayer time as they're getting acquainted. And then start with the getting started, the DVD, and the discussion questions. So whatever order you follow doesn't really matter, as long as you're consistent each week in what you do. So now I want to give you a couple of basic facilitator tips as you're going to be facilitating this small group, okay? So, a couple of basic facilitator tips. Number one, you want to make sure you cover one lesson per week if you can. The DVDs aren't too long. The lessons aren't too long. Make sure you keep the group on track, keep them focused, and keep them working through the material and staying focused on the material, but also keep working through it. Then, also, you want to make sure you cover the workbook, right? There's a lot of material in there. Make sure you go through it thoroughly. Don't really skip stuff. Don't just skip over it because you don't like it. Go through the material, work through it. If there's a question maybe you don't like or don't understand, that's okay to skip it. But the curriculum in here is designed to help people manage their finances God's way. And if you're skipping a bunch of sections and bouncing around, it's a little hard for people to, number one, follow you, and number two, learn it in the way that the folks have intended it. So a few other basic facilitator tips. It's good to remember that you facilitate, you don't teach, right? You're there to help the people watch a DVD, take some notes, and to get them talking about how they can manage their finances God's way and help them apply that material to their lives, right? And to hold them accountable each week, to gently hold them accountable, right? So you facilitate a discussion, but you don't teach or preach, right? That's the job of the DVDs and this workbook. It's good also to remember that application is more important than completion, okay? Application is more important than completion. Let's say you have six great people in your group. They really get into a lesson. They stay on topic. They've got some ideas. They're really talking about it. And you get through six of the seven questions, right? You don't quite get to those seventh question. It's time to end for the night. It's okay, because as long as they're talking about the material and how they're going to apply it, don't worry as much about completing the lesson if you feel like your group is really growing and finding ways to apply it. And then lastly, you want to follow up with your group members as they are learning, right? This curriculum is really great because it has some good follow-up questions, right? They call it the catching up section, right? And that's where you catch up from last week. What did you do? How did you apply it? How has your life changed, right? So you want to really focus on that and help the folks in your group learn and grow, right? And they might be busy. They haven't even picked up the book since last week. You know, cut them a little bit of grace and a little slack, but you really, you know, they're going to get more out of the group if they're actually applying the things they're learning, right? And that's your job as a facilitator, is to love them, be kind to them, but also encourage them to apply the material to their lives. Well, we do at our church, you might ask, well, what do I do about charging for the material? What we do at our church is we ask for a $10 donation to cover the cost of this book, $10. If people show up to their group and they forget their book, you might loan them one for the night, but be sure you get it back, okay? Because you don't want to just keep giving them another book each and every week, but ask for $10 to cover the books, and then from there you can loan them out, okay? So let me give you a brief overview of this study, Managing Our Finances God's Way. It's a six-session study, but it really has seven sessions because there's an introduction week by Rick Warren. And I really like this study, number one, because it is conversational, easygoing, and laid back. I don't know about you, if you've ever been through the Dave Ramsey course. I've been through it. As much as I love Financial Peace University, it's pretty intense and it's pretty direct. And Dave Ramsey will look people in the eye and tell them they're stupid and they're idiots. And it's a little intense for me. I like this because the guys, they come into the room, they sit down in a chair, and they talk to you. They don't yell at you or preach or call you dumb or stupid or an idiot, but they just talk to you as a brother and sister in Christ about what it means to manage your finances in a way that would honor God. And I really like that format, especially for a small group are for people that aren't really that well-churched, haven't been in church a long time. It's just a really great format. Another thing I really like about this study is the people in it. It's taught by several different guys. Rick Warren starts it out. Chip Ingram has a session. Ron Blue has a section. Howard Dayton has a section. And Chuck Bentley has a section. Okay, those are the guys that cover this material, and they all offer a unique perspective of varying ideas, but it's all very good and sound biblical things. One thing you want to watch out for this study, I noticed, at least in my DVD, as soon as you pop the DVD player in, it's really, really loud, and then when you start the sessions, it gets really, really soft. So you might just want to be aware of that with your group as you pop the DVD in. You might jolt them all awake if the sound is on too loud. So just make sure the sound is low when you first start the DVD, and then when the session starts, you can turn the volume up there. So one last thing I wanted to share with you. The fill in the blank notes, this is my book where you can see my fill in the blanks, they go pretty fast on the bottom of the screen. So once your group is there, once they have watched the DVD, before you start asking questions, I would suggest to you that you go back through and read the fill in the blanks, okay? That way, just to make sure everybody's got them. So the DVD plays, it stops, you say, okay, it's great to have you all here, we're gonna go through the questions, but before we go through the questions, I want to make sure we all got the fill in the blanks correctly. And just read the fill in the blanks. Just go through them very pedantically, but it's okay. Make sure everybody's on the same page. So this is a great resource, a great study. I highly recommend it. We're doing it at our church and trying to help people manage their finances God's way. If you have any comments or thoughts about how to use this study, maybe you've used it, we'd love to hear from you down there below in the comments. If you like this video and want to subscribe, you can subscribe to my channel up there. If you want to learn some more facilitator tips, I got a bunch of small group facilitator tips up there. If you are new at starting a small group, I got 10 tips that will help people show up to your small group over there. And then I got some other topical DVD studies over there if you're looking for another study after you do this one. Thanks for watching, and I hope to catch you again on another video.